So for this tutorial, I just want to go over a couple points that relate to how to get your orthographic sketches that you've done on paper into SolidWorks. And we're actually going to use Photoshop as our tool here. So what I've done is I've made a sketch on paper, and I've scanned it into Photoshop. I went ahead and scanned this in at 300 dpi, but normally, unless it's a super detailed sketch, a normal screen resolution of 72 dpi is sufficient. You notice that I scanned it in a little crooked. The construction lines here are supposed to be perfectly horizontal, and this is easy to fix in Photoshop. Just go over to usually where the eyedropper tool is here and click down on it. You can select the measure tool. Then you just find one of your construction lines, either horizontal or vertical, and you just measure to that angle that the construction line is drawn at. So this looks about right. You can see up here it says that that's a 2.4 degree angle, meaning it's 2.4 degrees off from the horizontal. So now what I can do is go up to Image, Rotate Canvas, Arbitrary, and this angle amount will be pre-entered into the dialog here. So I can just hit OK, and Photoshop will straighten out the image. That works with vertical lines too. Photoshop just knows whether or not you are trying to hit a horizontal or vertical, and it'll compensate automatically. So once we've straightened our scan, you might just want to open up the Levels tool to make sure you have enough contrast. This actually looks fine. But you know, I might want a little more contrasty image, or I might need to bring out the midtones a little bit. Usually that's not necessary for simple sketches. And then I'm going to use the Crop tool just to start isolating the specific orthographic views. So I'll start with the top view here. Take my Crop tool, maybe zoom in a bit. And I usually don't go all the way to the edges of the object, but you can get in pretty close. With symmetrical drawings, it can be helpful to make the cropped area symmetrical across the axis. That just can make things easier to place in SolidWorks later. So that looks pretty good. I'll go ahead and crop. And now I'm just going to save a copy of this. And I will call this top. JPEG is fine. Sometimes it can be good to use PNG, but JPEG can provide the most compression. It really doesn't make a difference, though, because once it's brought into SolidWorks, it's going to be saved in SolidWorks internal bitmap format. So I'll just say save here, replace. Compression doesn't really matter. This is just a general guide that we're going to be drawing by. Okay, now I'm going to go back and crop out my side view. Looks about right. We'll crop that and save the side view. That's all there is to it. So in the next tutorial, we'll actually bring these front and side, top and side views into SolidWorks.